What's up, you guys? The weekend continues. Yeah, I'm always in this jacket, right? It's just because it's my warmest furry jacket, and it's pretty cold out there. It's probably 40s right now. What I'm going to do today, in the hopefully the final video for the weekend, is some front and rear diff fluids. I even prepared and rebuilt my whole custom hose setup here for this particular job. So I'm expecting this to be super easy. Let me get my main lights on too. Yeah, brighten things up. Quick rundown on yesterday's depression and bad mood. Bad news, I should say, not bad mood. Well, questionable. Yeah, mainly when someone just pointed out the obvious, and then I thought back to all the things I've learned over the last 5 years and what I've seen and pictures I've seen. He said those drips on that pan were a water pump, and he was right. He was right. I obviously remembered that. And then I started looking at it, remembering those spots are pretty far apart. It might have had a more or less dense look in the middle there. That is your water pump drip. And then I looked right down under that water pump with flashlights and everything. And I see a little trail, you know, sure. I bet most of you would find that. So it's just time to think about, start doing the water pump. That's like my biggest fear for some reason, just because I've had so many GTIs. If I just learned how to do a water pump, man, I'd be set. I wouldn't even be worried anymore. But I've just never done the intake manifold. I'm sure I could do it. It's just the unknown, it's just the fear. And the whole thing, it isn't doing it. It's if I break something that I can't fix right away and my car's down. That's the main reason that there's so much fear there. I mean, I'm sure I could figure out how to take off the intake manifold, etc., and peek at my valves while I'm in there. We're going to be doing that too. But yeah, the big news, I have ordered a water pump and thermostat for this car. It was hella expensive. I went OEM with my partnership with Deutsch Auto Parts. I just like OEM. I know everybody likes the metal pumps and all that. I like the newest revision of OEM personally. And a careful install, of course, hopefully by me and maybe someone that helps. But yeah, I'm going to have to do the water pump at some point. My reservoir barely moves, so this isn't an emergency. I was feeling weird yesterday, and I kind of like went into a panic all of a sudden when someone mentioned it, and I went, oh shoot. And I suddenly got all this fear, like now I'm going to be driving around waiting for it to explode every day. And then I, you know, came back to reality. And I said, I launch control this thing. I drive hard every day. Nothing's ever happened. This isn't an emergency. Hopefully it won't blow. I need some wood. Fake wood? Nah, real wood. Hopefully it won't blow, you know, anytime soon. My parts are going to be on the way. But I have to find a partner to do that with. Someone that's done it before that has some idea what I look for, the areas I touch, etc. I just can't go into it blind, or I'm gonna have to pay someone. I'm gonna have to be stupid, but hopefully someone is willing to help me there. Anyway, I talked way too long on that. Let's go ahead and get to the axle stuff. So I'm gonna pull out the Forester, get it out of here, center this car, get it flat, probably do ramps and maybe jacks on each side to keep it flat. And I'll show you how easy I think it is to do the rear. The front's just about as easy, a little bit harder access, but I don't anticipate any problems. And I'm real interested to see how gold and honey-like that fluid is, or if it's a little darker. The car has about 24,000 miles. I forget if you saw the oil change video yesterday. At the end, I write down the mileage right in front of your eyes. But yeah, around 25,000 miles. Let's see how dirty these diffs look. I think after I've done that, so I did the Haldex. If I do these front and rear diff, I think the front is a combo transfer case is what I'm reading. And the engine oil, I think the only thing left that I would not have touched, aside from, you know, brake fluid and coolant, is the DSG. And I have all the custom DSG tools to do that too. So in the future, you know, in the next year, I might, you know, do the DSG fluid too, get everything super fresh. I don't think I did a DSG fluid on this one yet. I think it was my GTI. It's hard to remember at this point. So the first thing I'm going to show you is my prep, my setup, my vehicle layout, okay? So I got ramps in the rear. Then I went with my front jacks. under these, of course I blank out, the rail, I can't remember what it's freaking called. It has a specific name, obviously. Pinch weld, I believe. But then for extra security, I did do my Audi jack point jack stands for safety also, just so you know. A lot of people always talk about my safety. I don't show a whole lot, but I do have jack stands there for backup for these ramps and the front. I'm not going to be getting under the front right now. I know there's no jacks there. This is the rear job we're starting with, so let's get to work. This is still my broken GoPro, by the way. I'm just waiting for a small little case or a cover for my new one. I don't even want to risk anything. So I'm just, I'm going to get it covered properly before I do anything there. First off, the important thing is do not mix up your Haldex and your differential changes, okay? I have already changed my Haldex. Now I got to refresh. It must have been this. Yeah, it must have been this. Honestly, it's hard to remember. I did clear my filter a few months ago or whatever. It wasn't too bad. Don't guarantee me on this, as I'd have to check my video, but I think this is the Haldex drain and the Haldex fill, okay? Over here. So, front half, Haldex. Then we get to the diff that we're doing right here. Fill, drain, diff. Different than the Haldex, okay? Just so you know. I might tackle the front today too. I'm thinking about it. Ooh, that pipe. No, I guess it's fine. The downpipe is pretty close to the metal, but I don't usually have the car up this high. All right, so I'm gonna figure out, is this a hex? It's a hex. It's probably a six, is I think what I read. I wonder if there's a cool little shield or something I can put on these two studs. You guys will probably know that, and I don't know about the sway in the way. I know there's some covers that GTI Cha-Cha-Cha has told me a bunch of times. A cover that kind of clips to your control arm area, aerodynamic type of cover stuff. It isn't, you know, top of the list, but, you know, something I might think about someday. So let me go ahead and pop these fills and drains here, and we'll see what this fluid looks like. I can't wait to see it. All right, this is a good little point here. So your sway bar's in the way a little bit here, but if you sink this in, you got just a hair of clearance. So I would use the ratchet just for final, for loosening, and I guess I'll do the fill first, for loosening first, and then you have to manually do it with a little Allen or something. You're not gonna have room to back this out into the sway bar. Obviously you're not gonna be touching your sway bar to do this. So let me first see if my fill plug will come out with a careful. Easy. Excellent. All right, so I'm gonna tap in. The fill is a little bit easier. Hopefully you can see that pretty dang good with the last human angle. Now, probably nothing will come out, I say, but who knows? Let's see. There's a little washer. I'm going to reuse these. I'm sure you're not supposed to. I've also read that this is lifetime and you don't ever need to change it, but yeah, we know how that goes. Let me pull this out. I think it's loose and see if anything drips. I don't think so. Okay, you just hold it here, don't drop it. Not that it matters. So there we got one screw out. Oh, here's the camera, not the light. With no issues. So that one's out nice and clean. Perfect. All right, put that over there. Now, another quick one. Now, you could probably spray it and have just safer luck. I'm just easy. See, I broke it loose. And then I take this off and I have plenty of room to get this one out. This is definitely gonna drip. Let's get this ready and see what happens. Okay. I think it's out. Whoa. Oh, that is creamy crystal honey. Creamy crystal honey. There you go, rear. Now people have said the front will be dirtier than the rear. We're probably gonna find out. It's all you do. I do have the fluid. I always think about, did I mess anything up? Fluid's ready to go. So yeah, I'm gonna let this drain for a while. Whew, this stuff stinks. And when it stops pulling, we'll go ahead and try and fill this thing. Ooh, it's stinky. All right, now I'm using a tiny ratchet. Ooh, it really stinks. A tiny ratchet, don't wanna overdo it. I mean, I'm sure this is fine. I can always also recheck it rather than strip it out. So That's very tight. Very tight. Let me get a little rag. Ew, you have to throw out all, you have to throw out the rags when you're done with this type of job. And put them outside. It's gonna stink up your whole garage. All right. Wasn't a whole lot. Yeah. I mean, it's like 0.9 liter or some crap like that. All right, I'm ready to start pumping this. Now, there is a couple tips here on the pump. On the pump and dump. So, when I push this big old honker pumper in, it spilled just a hair, okay? Too much volume. So, I opened both of my bottles, right? I opened both of my bottles and I poured a little bit to tip up the other one to get it down a little bit. And now I gotta see if this is gonna overflow when I try putting in my pump in this one. Let's see here. All right, that comes off. I was confused for a minute. Let's see. Oh man, this is very tricky. Can I go up here? Okay. It's this big part, man. Let me see if it'll... I may have to pump without putting this freaking thing all the way down, too. It's coming up. It's coming up. Ooh, it's coming up. See that? I hope you're on camera. Yeah, I might be all right. Let me see if I can screw it in without making it overflow. Just a little. Man, these threads are hard to deal with. I could pump it without, you know, screwing it in if I wanted to. It'll work, but... Is this even the right... I think it is. Just weird. I don't know. Maybe this does have a custom freaking thread. Either way, I can do it. It's just very tricky if I can't put on the lid. One knockover, and I'm out of luck. So I can kind of go like this. That's what I'm going to do. I have to go like this. Watch the fluid. Get my tapper in here. Oh, can I go under without... Wait, come on, baby. Right, the red is in place. Yeah, it's in there perfectly. You can see that. Let me go up and give you the proper one. All right. Move this in and just pump until it leaks and we're done. Maybe you can see this freaking fluid jar also, which would be pretty awesome. I'm going to hold this. I'll clean up later. It's a mess. All right, I'm going to start pumping this thing. Let's go. Here it comes. Come on, baby. Oh, here it really comes. Yeah, it's a lot of freaking hose to be filling up with fluid as far as like a waste. Let me get you a little better angle here so I can move a little closer and keep an eye on this. Okay, move that up like that. Oh, whatever. When it spills out, it spills out. I like watching the bubbles and you know it's moving, right? I haven't even made a dent in this bottle yet. It's still at 900. So, you know, slow. You got small hoses. Don't push it hard. All of a sudden, the pressure is going to pop out and squirt everywhere. Slow and steady. This will take a while, but it's all about patience.
Lane fast, call it high speed. I've been working hard, yeah, I've been working nightly. If you think you'll win, ha, not fucking likely. I be taking shots, yeah, cold-blooded, icy. Watching numbers grow is what I call sightseeing. In the front row, run it up when they hype me. The following grows, they know how to ignite me. Call me CEO, I've been running shit right, see. And I ain't playing games, I create my own lane. Making pleasure out of pain, Turning losses into gains. I'm the boss, I'm making change. I've been rocking this exchange, Popping off and risking things. Gonna make a fucking name. I just wanna be famous. But I don't want that cheap fame. No, I'm not that vain. I just wanna be greatness. I just wanna be greatness. Try me. If you wanna hate, bitch, you know where to find me. And if you're going ape, I'm going off every chance I get. I don't really take a lot.
All right, guys, I finally got it. Wow, that's a lot more than I thought. Just want to get a little stronger drip. Oops, didn't even get any in that time. Here we go, here it comes. Okay, slowly pushing, I don't want to waste too much. I'm sure it'll drip out now, let me try it. Am I wrong again? There we go. It is dripping, that's perfect. Let me go ahead, even though my hands are all messed up, try and get this locked in. Let me get, not that I'll clean everything, but clean some of it that was left over and get this thing in and then finish cleaning it. That was more fluid than I thought. It almost looks like a freaking bottle and a half, which obviously it's not. It's just kind of looked like that. Very carefully, with fine hands, get this straight. I cannot even see what I'm doing. Hold on, guys. Oh my God, this is ridiculous. All right. Oh, my hands are too slippery. You motherfucker. Okay. There we go. Stop it for a minute. Actually, that'll just soak it up. Come on, I can't pull the socket off. My hands are too greasy. Oh, get in there. All I need is this thing. Come on, man. All right, I can get a better grip, maybe. Here we go. Start. Get in there. I think I got it started. I think. It's hard to tell. My hands are so slippery. Okay. Yeah, that's going in. That's going in. I think I stopped it. Whew. That was crazy. It sucked. Yeah. Pain in the butt. But still, super. I mean, I'm just sitting here looking at it. It isn't like it's hard. Definitely an easy mod for anybody thinking about it. But, I'm not sure if I want to freaking do the front now, given how much fluid I have left. And it probably won't spill, and then it'll just bug me, and then I'll have to freaking like redo it later. That's probably what's gonna happen. So if I don't start the front, then I'm okay. Can get one more bottle, have a spare, or whatever. All right, tiny little Titan with the tiny little ratchet. Make sure it's nice and snug. There you go, it's bottomed out. More than tight enough. Perfect. Now clean it. Almost all the fluid off so it doesn't stink too much. All right. Rear diff fluid is finally done. Pain in the butt, but you know, probably only time I do it in my whole life. You do this once. Now, the factory might say you do it never. But now I know I got super fresh fluid. Obviously it was cherry, it already looked new. It probably did not need, you know, changing, obviously. All right, guys, that is the decision I'm gonna make. I'm not gonna do the front. Let me show you how much I have left. A full bottle, right? Well, just about 1 liter. However, everything I read, say the front takes a little more, like a 1.1 maybe. This probably won't get it to drip. I don't want to do the job if I'm not going to be able to get it to drip and just be super satisfied that it's perfect. So as much of a waste as it is, I'm going to go ahead and order one more bottle of this, which I'll only use a quarter of probably, and then I'll tackle the front some other time. Anyway, thanks for checking out the rear diff fluid change. Good to know that it was super clean. It didn't even need replacing, so you guys probably don't even need to do it. But I just wanted to show you where it was and how to do it just one time. All right, guys, catch you later. Check you later. Come on, man, chicks don't want to hear that. Come on, chicks don't want to hear that. When I get to college, man, I'm gonna be banging everywhere. Bang, 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 bang. Closing statement, guys. You know I've been using this Braun for a long time. It's super used, it's served me great, right? But I needed a couple replacements, a little extra. So I got these little puppies off Amazon, and they are brighter than that thing. That's what I used in this video. A couple Defiance, twin by twin. The best part is they're magnetized. I mean, I gotta say it. The cheap Defiant Amazons are better than like the Braun. I think I got that at Harbor Freight or something. Probably paid double for this one. It's not as bright. I'm going to put links right down here. If you want to pick up a couple sweet lights, these are perfect. They just charge up and they have an output USB. So you could charge them at the same time, plug your phone cord into it while it's charging. And magnet is the best part. Just toss it on your toolboxes, wherever you want. On your car even, I wouldn't want to do that. Super cool. Defiant lights. No, I'm not sponsored. Just check them out for me. Check that link in the detailed description. Thanks, guys. See you later.